Hey guys, this is Bharadwaj with phonearena.com and this is the Gear S2, the first round smartwatch from Samsung. They released it at the IFA event in Berlin and we had attended that. We found a couple of things pretty cool. The first one is the circular UX. This device, as you can see, it comes in a round box, has a rotating bezel which you can use to use the UI, and this is a particularly new cool thing that Samsung has done. And also another cool thing is that the Gear now works with most of the Android devices, most of them meaning Android 4.4 plus and 1.5 gigabytes of RAM plus, which is pretty decent, I guess. So those are the two cool things that we noticed at the Gear S2 event. Now, this is the retail version. Let's see them in action in the unboxing and a first look at the Samsung Gear S2. Now let's get this already opened box open, because thank you Indian customs officers for not damaging the watch as much as the box. But here is the Gear S2 in black. This is the normal version, the basic one, and there is also the classic version which costs $350. This costs about $300, which is in the ballpark of about 18 to 20k. Not too cheap, but not that costly either when you compare it with the Apple Watch. But anyway, look at this in black. It looks pretty cool, this one. You can see that it's pretty thin and also lightweight, as we had seen at the event. The watch has the metallic rim and also silicone rubber bands. These are proprietary band locks or band mounts or whatever you want to call it. And the Gear S2 Classic will have traditional band support and also will look more traditional. This is Samsung's idea of a modern smartwatch, so it looks completely different. So it looks pretty cool, but let's keep that aside for a while and quickly take a look at the box contents and also the box here. You can see that there are some crucial information printed on it. You can see that it has a highlight of the specs. So there is a 1.2 inch circular Super AMOLED display on this watch. There is Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, NFC support, and the best thing, Android compatibility. Because previously, all the Gear watches used to work only with Samsung devices, which reduced its potential, really. Now, let's open the box. Must have the usual suspects here. Like, you have extra bands. This is the wireless charger, which you will use to charge the battery of the watch. And this is the cable, which is obviously micro USB. And there is also extra bands if you want larger bands or smaller bands. That's why they give it, because obviously not there is not a single size that fits everyone. And this is the charger, and of course you have a booklet to let you know all the functions and features of the Gear S2. Well, let's take a closer look at the watch, and damn, it looks pretty good in black. I had seen it in white and the Gear S2 Classic in black, but the black Gear S2, the normal one, looks pretty good indeed. Let's take a hardware look at the device now. The front has the screen, the circular Super AMOLED screen, and this is a rotating bezel which gives a very mild tick-tick impression. This is very physical, so it's not like a vibration or anything. It's just like the rotating bezel of previous normal watches that you used to have. Like, I used to keep rotating these dials before, and it's pretty cool to see that this is put in action digitally. Now, over the right, you have the power and the back buttons here, and there is also the microphone which you can use to send voice commands to. And over at the back, you have the heart rate sensor and the glass. The glass, as you can see, is pretty much of a fingerprint magnet, but it won't matter, it will be on your wrist. And there is also the new locking mechanism, which is like a quick release for these bands. These bands are proprietary, and you can get some colors if you need and swap them out, or if you want to use a larger band, then you can easily do it. That's the basic idea here. And yeah, that's about it for the hardware overview of this very simple looking design. It's very minimalist, and you can see not many controls, just two buttons, a microphone, and a rotating bezel. That's pretty cool. So I just charged the device using the magnetic wireless charger. You can see that the device just holds on to the magnetic charger like this. It won't fall off, and you can see that it is indeed charging. The red light glows on the charger, that's the LED, and I think this is pretty cool that it is magnetic. It's also fast charging enabled, which is very much needed for wireless charging, which has traditionally been very, very slow. So let's turn on the device and connect it to an XS6. I'm not sure which button turns it on, but there you go, that's the power button at the bottom. It just turned on and I'm gonna use it with the Samsung Gear Manager app that I just installed on XS6. So let's wait for it to boot up. So this is running Tizen. That's the new platform that Samsung wants to promote and use on most of its devices. You might have seen the smartphones too that they have released, but this is the smartwatch version, and it's pretty much been used already since the first Gear. Like the first Gear was Android, then they updated it to Tizen and a lot of variations. Now we have this with a circular UX. So let's see what happens. There you go, that's the pairing request. And yes, apparently you need to install a Gear S2 plugin which will enable you to communicate with the watch. I think it's asking for a lot of permissions. I think this is the special app that will let you have more control over the smartphone's functionalities to the watch. Probably that's why they have it. So let's get this installed and show you how it works. So there you go, this just connected to the watch. I think it's still saying setting up because I have not completed the options here. I'm just gonna agree to all. I'm gonna agree to all and hit done. And there you go. So this is how the notifications will work. So sign into your Samsung account to use these Gear features when Bluetooth is disconnected. So even when Bluetooth is disconnected, you can have your notifications show up on the Samsung Gear because this has Wi-Fi. If you connect the Wi-Fi, then obviously you'll get the notifications here. So that's how recently Android Wear also works. So I just signed into the Samsung account. Now I'm gonna turn on notification access. Straight away you can select the notification access here, and we can enable Samsung Gear from the Android notification access panel. And when you go back, you have a list of notifications that you can let appear on the watch. So not everything is selected. So firstly, only the main apps have been selected. All the other apps that are usually not going to push you a lot of notifications are not selected, which is pretty good. And yeah, I'll just go with the first 11 apps and hit OK. And these are the things that you can do with the Gear Manager app. So first up is, of course, watch faces. Now these are the watch faces that are available for you to change, and you can also create new watch faces with several templates. So this is going to be pretty useful for customization, but otherwise you still have a decent number of watch faces here that you can use. Interestingly, there are also a couple of third-party watch faces like the Nike watch face, CNN Digital and Bloomberg. So this will increase as time goes on, as third-party developers are given more control, or maybe even you will get more control. The notifications is pretty much the same. You can manage the notification. You can turn on the screen when receiving new notifications, and also limit notifications from certain apps. And when it comes to apps, these are the apps that you get. So these are the ones that are pre-installed, and they come in a circular menu. I'll show them in the watch. And you can also send media to the watch. You can select tracks, you can select images, you can send them and also make them store on the internal memory so that you can use them later. Now that's about send media. Then app settings, you have app settings for a couple of apps, and then you have Samsung Gear apps, which is the Gear app store that will take you to. And of course you can download new apps when they arrive. I'm not sure why it is so slow, but as you can see, it's already in Hindi, recognizing our region. And you have different clocks, you have different games, you have different utilities. So all these pretty basic now actually, but maybe this app list will expand soon. And also these are the all important settings. You can have double press for the home key. You can have text templates which are for SMS quick replies. You have the connection, which is on. Use the remote connection. This is through the Wi-Fi. The network will send off the notifications through Wi-Fi. And also you have an option to send SOS messages, which could be pretty useful in constrained times. And there's also backup and restore, which is pretty good. So these are all the features that you get in the Gear S2 app. Then of course you have the find gear, you have the status for all these things, and also remote control, reactivation lock and everything. Just tapping the search button will make the gear vibrate like this, and I can just dismiss it from the watch. So that's all the things you can do from the app. Now let's take a look at the watch. The watch is very interesting because of the circular UI and also the circular UX, which is kind of different but the same. But here's how it works. So you rotate the bezel, which will take you into different screens. So rotate to the right, you get the watch face and all the apps and all the widget like things that you can do. So these you can configure, add and whatever. So these are basically watch faces that are corresponding to certain apps and so on. Now going back to the watch face, you can see that you can change the watch face if needed by hitting the long press on the touch screen. So this is the basic watch face, and you have the other watch faces as well. As we had seen in the app, these are the same watch faces. So let me select something else and going into the first right section. So this is what happens when you turn one click to the right. You get four options. One is S-Voice, one is the buddy list for the favorite contacts, one is apps, and one is settings. So let's go there again, go into the apps first. So this is the circular UI and UX that we were talking about. This is pretty cool. Like this is basically the adaptation of the crown that Apple Watch introduced onto the bezel. So this is kind of new. Now going into the app is pretty simple. You just choose the app and hit the touch screen, you go in. And if you wanna go back, like for example, you hit the back button here. So very, very simple UI and UX. You can see that I'm rotating the bezel to the end and rotating it again to go into the next page. So that's how it will work. And even if you want to get more apps, you can do that from right here. So these are all the apps, and there are a lot of apps here. So I'm not going to show you everything, but show you only the basic user experience. Going into the settings, you can see this UI in action. This is pretty cool, really. There is also a vibration feedback for every menu item. So when you rotate, you get a physical click when you rotate, and also a vibration click, which is part of the experience. The storage inside is 4 GB. Out of that, you'll get 1.89 GB for all your images and also your music. There is also NOX. There is the serial number, the MAC address, the model number and everything. And also it runs on Tizen. So that's what you get. There is also report diagnostics and usage, reset and debugging and all that into the gear info. There is also power saving, which will help you in times when the battery is low, just like now. So now I'm turning on power saving. You can't access any other functions of the device. You can have notifications and you can have the basic screen in black and white. So that's the power saving mode, and you can turn it off right away. So that's basically a quick intro to the UI of the Gear S2. It works pretty well, and the circular UX is pretty cool, and it even has multitasking here, as you can see. It's pretty cool. You can close all apps, and the new Tizen UX is pretty radical for a smartwatch, I would say. So that's pretty much it. I want to show you a lot more, but I'll reserve that for a complete review. So that's it for the unboxing and a first look, a rather in-depth look into the Gear S2 and its circular UX. Do hit the like button if you like this video, and of course subscribe to the channel for more videos like these. Thanks for watching.